Welcome back to the channel. As you can see, we're right in the heart of Nuremberg, and we've just come around the corner to what looks like there's going to be some kind of parade. Police everywhere, and it looks like they're going to do some kind of march.
Standing to attention.
So let's see what's going to happen. The police are blocking the road and everything, aren't they?
Yeah.
Got some kind of band waiting to go as well there, Mark, look. There he is. Everyone was saying, where's Chico on the last one? He's here.
We've still got him. He's not run away yet.
He's got his pink jumper on and his coat.
We literally walked around the corner. We haven't got a clue what's going off, have we?
No, we just thought, crack, what have we walked into here? The church behind in the background, that's called St. Sebald's Church. Oh, there you go. Right on time.
That's them depressing bells I keep going on about. Yeah, go on, don't
depressing.
We are, aren't we?
I think it's like a gather around or all come together bell, that, isn't it?
Führer der Gelöbnisaufstellung, Herrn Major Eduard Tierbach. Insgesamt legen 92 Soldatinnen und Soldaten der 7. Kompanie angetreten in der Formation und im Ehrenzug ihren Diensteid bzw. ihr feierliches Gelöbnis ab.
So we're thinking that's some kind of like passing out parade. They did tell us what it was, but it was all in German, weren't it?
Yeah, we're talking. It's finished now. I think they've gone. Done.
All done. All done and dusted.
Police will be going soon. So.
Yeah, everywhere. Look, right next to us. Everywhere we go. Right, so we're just going to walk into the old part of Nuremberg. Fire truck. And see what all that's about. There's something just around the corner here, isn't it? What was it called? Sunnebrunner?
Something like that, yeah.
Let's go and have a look. Looks like we might find the local registry office as well. Someone's getting married there. What a good day, what a nice place as well. This is the old market square, I do believe. And if I'm not wrong, that is the Sunnebrunner.
But what does it do?
I have no idea, Mark.
Does
looks
it spin
pretty.
Around or something?
I don't think so. I'll tell you what it looks like. You know when you go to German markets and you see those wooden looks like that. So yes, this is called definitely a Schönenbrunnen. Now it's a 14th century replica. It's actually supposed to be a fountain. I don't know if it still works. It may do. It does look like it might work, but it's a replica. It's supposed to look like a spire, which it does.
It's not food though, is it? And I'm hungry.
Oh guys, again we've made the big mistake of coming out without any food. So he's after a doner. What time is it? 12 o'clock.
Oh, past 12.
But like we were saying, everyone seems to eat them for breakfast here as well, don't they? It's very strange. Well, he's finally got one. Doner kebab.
Yeah. That's what we want, isn't it?
What did you get it on? A wrap?
On an oriental bread, they call it.
It's
either like a big, thick, stodgy, butty thing or an oriental bread. So I said oriental bread.
So it's come to somewhere called Sultan because it claims it's the best in the town. And that's just pure doner, isn't it? You don't have salad on yours.
No salad, no. Do you want to have a look at it? See what we've got. Got it. Look at that. Do you want some?
No, you're all right.
They make this fresh bread. They put it in like a pizza oven or something.
First doner in Germany.
Can I try a bite?
No, you're all right.
You could have got chicken.
Yeah, I don't fancy it. I've had no breakfast, no. I've had a cup of tea and that's it. How much for that?
$8.90.
Really? That's a lot, isn't it? Enjoy. Oh, well, you've got a bonus dinner there, haven't you? So you just had doner kebab. And now he's ended up with a sausage bat because I asked her one and she did us two. but I've got sauerkraut on mine. Has anyone ever had sauerkraut? It's really nice.
Smells like tea bags. I've took mine off.
Tea bags. So yeah, let me get my dinner. That were a bit disappointing, that sausage sandwich, weren't it?
That's good. As the other day, what we had, mine went anyway. Probably did help because I've just had a nice dinner as well beforehand. So.
Yeah, I don't think you were exactly very hungry, were you?
No.
Look at these you can buy. Look at these. Oh, really? You could put Chico in there, couldn't we?
Yeah.
That's well smart.
Put that one at front, look. Like
they're actually designed for this, aren't they? You could put kids in there.
Yeah, seatbelt.
Oh my goodness, they're getting bigger, Mark. Wow. We have seen a lot of these, haven't we, with lights on and things. Look at that, with two kids things in front.
Yeah.
Oh, I'd be a bit nervous, me, about driving with my kids in front like that. What's this one for a wheelchair, Mark?
Oh, yeah.
Wow. That's amazing, isn't it, for mobility?
Yeah.
Blinking heck. Yeah, I've never seen anything like those before. So we've just come down. This is like oldish new. It's very quiet, isn't it?
It's quiet,
for a city,
isn't it?
It's very quiet. Nuremberg. We're just going to go down this way because I believe there's some kind of river or canal that comes through the centre.
Yeah, it's funny, isn't it? It's big. It is big, isn't it?
We're massive. It's huge.
We're not going to get a chance to look around all of it.
No.
No way, not today. So.
It's like a mixture of old and new again, but a lot more newer than where we were in Rothenburg. That was like medieval, weren't it?
Yeah.
We've got a slight cold wind coming in today as well.
It is cold,
a bit nippy,
isn't it?
I should say.
We had a few days of warmth, didn't we? Now we're back to cold again now, so.
But it's all south after this one, isn't it? We're heading south.
Well, we're going to have to work a route because we're flanking sort of Austria, aren't we, to go back towards, well, Dolomites that way, but we don't really want to go into Austria because the emissions things with the motorhome. So.
Yeah.
But I think there's snow as well down there at the minute, which no doubt is most time of the year.
Yeah. So there we are. We found it. This is one of the bridges that goes across in Nuremberg.
What's this, a canal bridge
there? I don't know. That's what I was wondering myself. Can you imagine living there, though? How pretty is that? So we've just found out that this used to be a wooden bridge and then it's been replaced by a stone bridge, but there is still some wooden bridges down the way. And this connects the main bit of Nuremberg to a flea market. So I'm just going to come and have a look and see what we can find in here. I don't think there's much going on today. What day are we on? Thursday?
Yeah.
Very quiet, isn't it, for a Thursday? It to the top of the Imperial Castle in Nuremberg, and the views up here, as you can see, Mr. Telescope Man here is looking right. It's free, but look at this. Are you ready? Pardon?
There's a woman in a window naked down.
All right, well, I'll leave you here and I'll go and get a coffee.
Do you want me to show everyone?
No. Everyone's screaming at the telly now, show us, show us! I'm sure this is just going to look like you'd have food all day long. One thing after another, isn't it?
That's the first one I had since early on.
Is this your afters?
You made me have a cake.
I've made you have a cake.
Yeah,
I don't think so.
Right,
yeah, I'm going to have a try of it. What did you say? I thought you put with on a chocolate cake.
Cinnamon flavoured.
It's cinnamon flavoured. Is it nice?
Mm-hmm.
And the good thing is, Chico's are allowed in as well, aren't you?
They're not huns in,
they? Yeah, he's called a hund. So I just asked if he could come in because it was getting really cold. And yeah, it was lovely and warm in here. So we're in the Imperial Castle Cafe. I don't know how much things are going to cost, but when you're getting too cold, you don't care, do you?
It has turned cold, hasn't it?
It has turned cold, yeah.
I've got one thing to say about this cake, Lisa.
What about it?
It's moist.
Oh, Christ.
I'm not convinced it's all old. It's a lot of it looks new, Lisa.
It does, but it's just well maintained, isn't it?
Yeah.
There's bits are very, very old, and there's bits that look like they've been tarted up a bit, shall we say?
Yeah.
But it's definitely...
Really new, but...
what, 16th century, would you say? I would. I'm sure I've seen it said something like that. 15th, 16th century. It's like these bits here, they look quite new, don't they?
Yeah, and then that in front of us looks quite old.
And then you've got like old bits like this.
Mm. Yeah, I can't put my finger on it.
Mark must be waiting for old skeletons to be showing or something like that to prove that it's old.
Steep, isn't it? It's
a this is steep, yeah, this is very steep. It's up on a hill, is Nuremberg Castle, so...
It's supposed to be €5 or something, isn't it, to get in?
Yeah, to go in the bit, there is a bit there that you can go in and have a look round inside, but like I said, it's not our thing, is it?
No.
I mean, look at this wall here. They didn't want you getting in, did they?
It's like rock in it, although they're bricks, aren't they, but like weather.
It's not for the faint at heart, we're walking. I'm surprised I fetched him up here, actually, because I'm surprised he hadn't gone flying.
Yeah, we entered from round the back and it's a gradual walk up there, isn't it?
Yeah, now it's a steep decline back down into the town. It's on. You find it, take a picture with it, and we'll put you on Instagram, Nuremberg.
So we've done a complete circle, we're back to where we started, aren't we? Like
exactly,
in the centre, town centre, where all the marching was earlier.
And we've walked for ages and we've gone right round in a circle.
Yeah. Seems big, but isn't it? And you know, the other thing what I keep thinking as well, the shops here, I can see all these shops, and if someone said to me, what do we sell? I ain't got a clue. Because they have shops with displays and stuff, and I'm thinking, what are they actually selling?
It is a lot different to England, a lot different.
Yeah. But it's somewhat similar, isn't it? Like the countryside when you drive in, similar, but yeah.
I know what you're missing. You're missing your own bargains and your Poundland. That's what it is.
Yeah.
Well, there's none here.
I can go and look at cable ties and bungee straps and stuff like that.
Oh,
and duct tape.
Duct tape.
Where do you want to go now? Around shops?
Not around shops, but I want to go and see what's down here.
There's no charity shops here.
There's not. And I've not seen any Chinese either. But they're all Donna shops, aren't they?
I've
Donna
seen
and
some Vietnamese and stuff like that.
No, someone did actually say there was charity shops, thrift shops, I think they're called, but I can't find any guys.
Oh, never mind.
On a good thing, I have seen a lot of clothing shops, and they're not that expensive. I thought it would be really expensive, and we're in a city as well. There's a lot of places like £5.99, really cheap. So unless every place is charity shops, I don't know, but definitely haven't seen any.
Seen this, haven't we?
Yeah, quite fascinating actually. This building behind us, it's been selling gingerbread here from about 15th century.
Yeah.
That's crackers. And it's been totally destroyed twice and rebuilt.
Rebuilt. The roof's different, isn't it now?
Yeah, it looks a bit different. Yeah, you can see the difference in it, but wow.
I was just looking, in World War II, it was heavily bombed. This city was absolutely smashed to bits, wasn't it? So by the looks of it anyway, from the pictures, there was not a lot left.
No.
Unbombed, weren't they? So that's why a lot of the buildings look quite new, I guess, isn't it?
But 1,400 years this building has been selling gingerbread. That's mental, isn't it?
Yeah,
we smelt it, didn't we, coming down the road? If you've ever smelt German gingerbread, you know. It's a really nice smell. I think this looks a bit like a little Venice, Mark. You know, but there's waterways everywhere, aren't there, in the city?
Like canals, aren't
you? Don't normally get this much water in a city, do you?
Splits off three ways there, look.
Starbucks.
Yeah, weird, isn't it?
Again, they've got a lot of talking tours here, aren't they?
Yeah, all in German.
I was trying to listen then and she was in German, so I was trying to nick some information off her for you, but I didn't understand a word of it. So Chico's going to retire for a bit. He's getting a bit tired, aren't you, darling? There you go. You go to sleep. I don't mean you. Come on, you can carry on walking for a bit.
Have you got a rucksack I can get in now?
That'd have to be one big bloody rucksack, I tell you.
That's the only thing, isn't it, bringing you lot round these city centres? It's a lot of walking and stuff, isn't it?
I don't mind it, but he gets tired, don't you?
Yeah.
Bless you.
Yeah. Look at this, what Lisa's got, look.
Yorkshire tea. This is what I need after a day like today.
So it got an olive bottom, hasn't it?
I think it's a planter, but God, that'd make a purling cup of tea, that.
And this is a store called Butler's at Home, isn't it?
Butler's at Home. I've seen one of these in every single city and town we've been to. It must be like the German equivalent of Home Bargains.
Right, we do all this sort of stuff. Easter and stuff like that.
Easter and stuff like that?
Mm. More shops.
After a full day of travelling and finally getting parked and set up, there is nothing more we love to do is sit down, kick back and enjoy a glass of excellent wine. So this week's sponsor couldn't be any more perfect for us. Wine 52 is one of the top online wine clubs in the world. Every month they send members a box of wine all over the globe, so we thought we'd give it a try. In the box you'll receive 3 bottles of Pure Delight. You can choose a box of all white, all red, or a box of mixed like me. I have chosen a lovely red from the Argentina region of Bodeguía San Juan de la Frontera called Hijo del Sol. Because this full-bodied wine is a masterpiece of balance and power with rich harmonious aromas, bold fruit flavours and a smooth velvety finish. Not only can you enjoy the wine, you can also enjoy reading about where your wine has come from in the award-winning magazine they supply to you called Glug. And if it couldn't get any better, the lovely people at Wine 52 even supply you with snacks to go with your drinks. Don't tell Mark though. So if you fancy a free box of exclusive wines from Argentina, click on our link below. That's wine52.com/northerners. That's wine52.com/northerners. And for just $9.95, that will cover the cost of the postage, you'll receive a box for free. Yes, for free. Click on the link in the description below. Remember, you can cancel or pause your order at any time. You've just got some trainers.
I know, look at it, look.
What is it?
It's called Donga.
Vending machine for trainers?
It's one of them things you get at a funfair or whatever, don't you, at Blackpool, and you put your money in, and you have to unlock it, don't you, with that key.
I've no idea. I've never seen it like that.
Why have you got one leg, innit, but you only get one if you win one trainer, don't you?
One trainer.
You do, don't you? Whether you take your one in, I don't know.
You only get one trainer.
Yeah.
It's worth the money then, isn't it?
They wouldn't
stay that colour, would they, in Van Laaf?
No, if I were getting something for you,
yeah,
I would guess what I'd get you for if I were getting you some footwear for standing.
Them?
No.
What?
I've got you them.
Oh, dear me.
And a pair of tights.
And you wonder why I don't let you go shopping for me.
A nice pair of dark tights to go with them.
Yeah. Where he gets his fashion sense from, I do not know. Uh-oh, I see the lanterns of hell. What have you seen?
Look at size of menu.
It's massive, but do you understand it?
Yeah, of course they do. Seafood dishes.
Chicken dishes.
Rindfleisch, chop suey.
What are you looking at here now?
Noodles and rice dishes. Look.
How much?
Shrimps and chicken, $13.80.
Wow.
Fried rice with beef, $11.80. But that's your restaurant, and it's very good, because that lady just said...
That lady just come up to us while we were filming. She said, very good.
Good.
So it must be good. Yeah. But not for that price. $13.80 for rice.
Yeah, but sit in, Lisa.
I don't care.
You get everything when you're sitting. You get knife and fork and plate and everything.
So I don't know if you've ever seen, cinnamon rolls in England?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah? This shop does all the cinnamon ones, but different flavours. Look at those.
And it's called Cinnamood.
Cinnamood, it's called. That's a bueno one, Mark. Salted caramel. Banana bread.
Oreo.
Oreos. And it's got a massive queue on it. It must be very, very good.
Yeah. They're nice. Look nice, don't they?
Mmm. Ones up there with cream on them, Mark, up there, and apples.
I know.
Apple is massive in Germany.
Apfel.
Apfel. You've got apple strudel as well. That's big here, isn't it? Apple. Cinnamon and apple.
Yeah. Strudel.
So Mark's had enough. We're just about to leave the town centre, get back. But look at this, in behind us, we think it's a very, very, it's a gorgeous fountain, but
graphic,
have you ever seen anything like this before?
Booby doobers.
Skeletons farting on the back of a chameleon.
With booby doobers. And then further around there, what is around there?
I'm not even showing you what's around there.
There's full male nudity around there, further
yeah.
around.
So if you want to come and have a look, you'll have to come to Germany.
Male genitalia.
You're okay then. Right, so we'll leave it there. We're going to go.
See you
there,
Lisa.
See you
there. Mm. Yeah. So Lisa's been shopping, spending money again, haven't you?
Right. You know when you're in England and you buy something and they say, do you want a bag and you've got to pay for it? Look at this one I've just got. Beautiful. Look at that fabric bag for nothing. And I've only spent €10 for free. And I've been getting some hair conditioner, that's all. Nothing special.
You can't buy that back
You
home.
Can't get it in England anymore. I used to get it all the time, and it were about €1.99. Yeah. €5 over here. But it's such good stuff. I've bought two bottles. But yeah, come on, England, get in with it. You don't need to charge for your bags. Has anyone else noticed as well, Primark have started charging for bags and the paper.
There's a
they
few
rip
are, aren't they,
as soon as you get out.
Morrison's, up some at supermarkets do, don't they, charge for paper bags? And first bit of rain, then we're no good.
I only thought you had to charge when it was plastic and it advertised their name on the side of it, but paper bags have always been free from Primark. Mm. Not good, that, charging. And they don't tell you either, they just add it onto your receipt, so be careful.
Well, they bag everything up automatically, don't
they?
Yeah,
they do.
Whether they want it or not. So if you're looking for a kebab in Nuremberg when you come visiting, you're definitely not going to not get one, are you? They'd be absolutely everywhere, Lisa, here, aren't they?
They are absolutely everywhere. Can you see them in the background?
And that would be nice, that one, idea. They're on from that place, were nice, but they either sell them on street food stalls or even in the shops, aren't they?
And you've only seen one Chinese up to now, haven't you?
Yeah.
So doner kebabs galore, Chinese, hardly any at all.
What it's famed for. So.
Did the doner kebab generate in Germany then?
It was Turkey, wasn't it? But Germany's always had some history of it, I think.
I don't know why, but I thought it was Greece. Comments below where the doner kebab was first made.
We don't do it right though, because we should get the bread and rub it up and down the meat and get the grease off the meat, shouldn't they? That's how we should do it as it's cooking.
So. Nice. Good morning. And we have left Nuremberg. We left Nuremberg last night.
Yeah, because it was a bit noisy where we parked. Being on the edge of a city is too much noise, isn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah, and look at what we've got. We are in...
Ansbach.
Ansbach. We haven't picked it for the place. We've picked it for the stopover. Because this is a bit special, isn't it, this?
Mm, yeah.
We are at a caravan and motorhome place.
Yeah, it's like
sales place.
Sales service and everything else. We're going to have a look around, aren't we? And this is free, all these. Although there's customers' cars in here this morning.
Yeah, but look at this. You've got grey waste. You've got... What is that, Mark?
Water
You've
toilet.
Got grey waste, toilet, water.
Everything.
And guess what? It's free to stop here.
And last night we plugged in and someone credited some money on. Must have been about, well, they had the eating on low all night and it were for free.
Yeah, all for free, so we've not paid a thing.
Charged battery and everything, so.
We're just parked there. They've got individual spots. Like I say, some customers have parked the cars in here today, but it is for motorhomes.
Yeah.
But because they've done that, we're going to go and have a look around and see what a German motorhome and caravan show place looks like.
Well, I want it, hopefully, if it looked like it would be very well stocked inside, but I want a new filter for the sog on the toilet door, so it's never been replaced. And being the sog's German, there's a good chance we'll get one.
Yeah, and if you want to know where a sog is, put it in the comments below, because if you haven't got one, you need one. They're brilliant, especially if you've got a Mark who likes takeaways. That'll give you a hint. Anyway, what's it called? Nagel.
Yeah.
Nagel.
Freisfeld Nagel.
This is where we are.
So it's Wohnmobiles and caravans. A Wohnmobile, or Wohnmobile, is a motorhome, isn't it? So.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Wohnmobile.
Look
at all this lot here. They've got all sorts. But yeah, places like Brownhills and where else is there? All your big places that sell motorhomes and caravans, if you did that, you'd have people coming and stopping the night, and the next day they come around and look at all your products.
Well, we'll definitely buy something, because I'm going to see if I can get some pipe from here. If I can get the pipe, I'll replace that water pipe that's leaking. I've tried to super glue it, but nothing will stick to it. It's funny rubber, isn't it?
There's a big accessories place here, isn't it? You got all excited
massive.
Last night.
I'm going to have a right good route.
We've only just walked in and not seen this caravan. My God, it's like a hotel on wheels.
I've never heard of it. It's called Tabert Cellini, and it's like a tag axle. It's like a big touring thing, isn't it?
Look at this. And we've always said you get a lot more space in a caravan than you do a motorhome, but my goodness. Look at the kitchen. Look at the width. You could lean across that, couldn't you?
In here, it's warm. Get telly what pops up.
You've got your fridge there.
Again, we don't normally show
big
stuff
big bedroom,
like
no we don't, but we show things that are a bit spectacular. This is just like being in a hotel, isn't it?
Yeah.
Look at the bed.
Bathroom, massive.
Is it? Another pop-up telly. That's two you've got, one in the bedroom. Bit dark in here. Oh my God, it's massive.
Well,
I thought it's normally about this wide, yeah, isn't it? But look at that.
Massive, man.
Wow. Two-person shower.
Yeah.
Wow, this is off the scale, isn't it?
Yeah. Right, let me go and look for my sog filter.
Yeah, I just wanted to show you this quickly because it's worth showing. Very nice. So we found one thing we want to buy anyway. We're looking for these all over in England when we were back home, when we were back over there. But that little thing there, might just be the answer to our sink. It's still backing up, isn't it? It's still not draining really fast.
Still not right.
Mark's had the pipe off, haven't you? So it must be something between the sink and wherever the blockage is. So hopefully this little fella's going to do the job.
Get moving.
Can't find any sog stuff though, can we?
No, I
wanted
don't.
A sog filter.
Don't like to do it, does it?
Mark's convinced that they're made in Germany.
Yeah, it's German made, yeah. So.
But I thought they'd have had them in here then, wouldn't you?
Mm.
And we might have found some storage solution as well, but I've got to go and measure the van first. Because I want some little storage pockets next to the bed where we can put our phones in when we're charging at night. But I've never found anything that looks desirable, but these look quite nice. So fingers crossed, they're the right size and I can get them and I'll show you them. Right, so we've made some purchases. We have bought one plunger for this bloody sink that's doing me head in. And some pockets. Look at these, grey ones.
Put them for his phone.
That one's open, Mark, there, that I've got in my hand.
Yeah.
Yeah, for next to the bed. Because everything I've seen, they like them black mesh things, I just don't like them, but these are like good quality ones, don't they, Mark?
Yeah, they're quite well made, aren't they? So, rather than put hooks in, well, we could use them hooks what we've got, them command strip hooks.
Probably they'll hold when you've got stuff in them. They're all right, them, aren't they?
Yeah, put your phone and Durex and stuff in there, can't you?
So funny. Yeah, so this sink, you're going to have a go at it or not?
I'll put some water in first, because what we need, well, I'll run it first. It just, it works, but it's slow, isn't it?
It's really slow. And when it's as slow as that, it leaves like a residue in the sink, and then it stinks.
Right, can't
I? And then you have to start cleaning your sink and then it fills with water and then it doesn't drain again. It's just like going around in circles.
It's got water in
there. See how that's taking some time now? Just be, don't be so heavy handed. Is it doing anything?
Oh yeah, no.
Can you feel it sucking?
Yeah, a little bit. Near it buzzing and stuff, can't you? Bubbly. Seems to do
see,
bit,
it come, see it coming back up?
Yeah, I don't know why it should do that. Unless the pipe's collapsed somewhere. We seem to be having a problem ever since it froze up in Scotland, haven't we?
Yeah.
That's the thing.
And regards the water under the seat, we've done a temporary fix on it for now, but we are still having to leave it empty. So it's all empty under there, so I've got stuff galore all over the bed.
Better,
is it getting better?
I think so. Look, it's not filling up as much now, is it? Yeah.
Can you actually see a swirl of it going down? Because I can't. That's what I think. That's when I know it's blocked. Still coming up, innit? Oh!
Sounds better.
That was a good gurgle. Oh well, I'm sure we'll get it fixed. So we'll get these up and we'll show you in the next vlog what they look like, these pockets. But for now, we need to get moving. We are going to Dinglesburg. Is it Dinkelsburg? Somewhere like that. Next, and you don't want to miss it. Because it's quite another, quite special German town. Still heading south. Mark still has it. And by the way, we didn't tell you that caravan that we showed you. Is it a Tabert, Mark? A Tabert?
Yeah, slider, isn't it?
It had a slider on the side. That's why the kitchen was so wide. But for that, you get a nice bit of money taken out of your bank. It's £133,000.
Only. No, euros.
Euros, even. For a caravan. Anyway, we'll tell you how we get on with the sink in the next one. If you've liked this video, please like, give us a thumbs up, comment, and make sure you
subscribe. And I'll have a shave if you do.
Please subscribe then, because it's driving me nuts. And we will catch you on the next one.